Tributes are being paid across the world to Archbishop Desmond Tutu, who has died at the age of 90. He dedicated much of his life to campaigning against apartheid in South Africa and was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1984 for his work.
Raise our hands and we say, we will be free!
Desmond Tutu was the country's moral conscience when most anti-apartheid leaders in South Africa had been silenced and imprisoned. A leader of the congregation who also led the protest march, he was never afraid to step in or chide the authorities.
The reason he was, as Mandela said, public enemy number one to white South Africans was that he got under their skin because he spoke out. He used to quote the book of Jeremiah in the Old Testament and say, like Jeremiah the prophet, I have to speak out. I'm actually a retiring kind of a person. But I have to speak out, and it's the anger which drove him.
During some of South Africa's most turbulent years, Tutu made the case for comprehensive reform, and his efforts won him the Nobel Peace Prize in 1984. And it was he who held up Nelson Mandela's arm as the first democratically elected president in 1994.
Day for which we have waited for over 300 years. This is the day of liberation.
Mandela promised to investigate the crimes of the apartheid era, and Desmond Tutu was the obvious choice to lead the process through a Truth and Reconciliation Commission. But it wasn't easy, and the Archbishop very publicly broke down. Midway through the commission, he was diagnosed with prostate cancer, but it didn't slow him down. The man known as South Africa's naughty uncle continued to laugh and engage. And criticize as well. His democratic rights used to castigate domestic politicians, here condemning a decision by the ruling ANC to refuse the Dalai Lama a visa.
Our government is worse than the apartheid government.
By the time of Nelson Mandela's death, Archbishop Tutu had fallen out with the authorities. His family said he wasn't invited to Mandela's funeral, a charge which led to a hasty last-minute invitation. The government of then-President Jacob Zuma said it was a misunderstanding. A few months later, Tutu said he wouldn't vote for the ruling ANC, a decision his daughter also backed.
He is disappointed with the assaults on our democracy, with the levels of corruption, with the amounts of graft, with the wanton wastefulness.
He made one of his last public appearances in Cape Town when he met Archie, son of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. His infectious sense of fun was on full display. He will be remembered for his energy and decency, his authenticity, a South African icon who was loved and appreciated far beyond his homeland. John Sparks, Sky News.